करूं। सो इन दिस टॉपिक टुडे वी शैल स्टार्ट फर्स्ट विद द ऑनसेट ऑफ साउथ वेस्ट मॉनसून एंड देन विदड्रॉल ऑफ दिस मॉनसून। इंडियन ओशन बे ऑफ बंगाल अरेबियन सी so with the influence of monsoon trough in north india the winds are attracted from indian ocean and this southwest monsoon is divided into two branches this is bay of bengal branch Bay of Bengal branch and Arabian Sea branch. Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch. So the southwest monsoon is divided into two branches. Let us see how these two branches move. Let us once again locate here Western Ghats, then Central Highlands. And this Aravali mountain and of course this mighty Himalayas and this Purvachal and of course extension of purvachal here arakan yoma mountain arakan yoma mountain so let us see first arabian sea branch On 1st June, this branch enters in Kerala, southern part of Kerala, and by 10th June, this branch reaches to Mumbai. Here, Thiruvananthapuram. So. This branch first of all attack western coastal plain and western ghats and cause rainfall here and then the branch enters in inner part like this this way Let us see this first. After causing heavy rainfall along western coastal plain, because the air moist air is lifted here by western ghats. When this branch enters in inner part, in this part of plateau, rainfall is low because descending winds do not cause rainfall here, and this is in the rain shadow area. But these winds when enters in inner part of plateau or northern part of plateau further they are uplifted by the central highlands and rainfall is increased. Now one branch of this Arabian Sea branch enters through Gujarat and Rajasthan and then reaches to North India. Here they pass parallel to Aravali. That's why this part of Rajasthan experiences very low rainfall, and then this branch enters in inner parts of subcontinent, Haryana, Punjab, etc. Important fact is here that this branch is passing parallel to this eastern coastal plain or Coromandel coast, mainly in Tamil Nadu. This is important fact to be mentioned here. Parallel to it, and rainfall is less in this area. The Bay of Bengal branch, other important fact, this Bay of Bengal branch is also not touching this Coromandel coast. So this coast of Tamil Nadu is devoid of both the branches, Bay of Bengal branch as well as Arabian Sea branch. That's why this part received very low rainfall or negligible rainfall in this area. Now see the direction of wind. It completely southwesterly. Direction of wind of this branch, Arabian Sea branch, and Bay of Bengal, both branches are southwesterly. But the direction of wind of both the branches can be affected by the role of topography. Role of topography. As sometimes this branch can take this turn here under the influence of topography. Now let us see this branch. After striking to Arakan Yoma mountain in Myanmar, in this area direction of wind becomes this southeasterly to northwesterly. So this is the role of topography or relief in the direction of wind, over the direction of wind of the monsoon. And in this Ganga Delta, direction of wind is this, completely south to north. Bay of Bengal branch in Ganga Delta have this direction of wind, south to north and southeasterly to northwesterly after striking to Arakan Yoma mountain. And when this branch reaches here, it deflected in two directions. One branch towards the Brahmaputra Valley, west to the east, and other branch in Ganga Valley from east to west. And here, the two branches are joining. Confluence of the two branches in northwestern part of plateau. But we will see the direction of wind is this here. General direction southwest to northeast. So this way two branches are advancing in the country, and you can see that here the two branches are joining together, and a joint venture of the two branches strike to this western Himalayas, and after causing rainfall in this area, when this branch enters to the northern part of Ladakh, in this area rainfall is very less, and you can say the rain shadow area is developed in this area also, north part of Jammu and Kashmir or Ladakh region. So this way the monsoon winds enters in the country, and this is known as onset of monsoon. And Again, let us start. This start by 1st June and then by the mid of July, by 15th of July, the monsoon winds covers the whole country. Entire India is under the influence of monsoon winds. And this, if we will see more specifically, these winds, this way they move, and in the end, the monsoon reaches to this part of Rajasthan. In the end, western part of Rajasthan experience rainfall, and this rainfall is mainly by the Bay of Bengal branch, because one point to be noted here, Arabian Sea branch passes parallel to the Aravali mountain. So this is how the onset of monsoon is done in the country. Now let us see withdrawal of monsoon. This is how monsoon withdraws. As we learnt here that onset of monsoon or entry of monsoon in India is due to the low pressure area in this area, or monsoon trough developed in this area, and this monsoon trough and low air pressure area is developed due to the intense heating of the land and vertical of rays of sun over Tropic of Cancer. But now the sun is having the tendency to move towards south after 21st June. As sun moves to the southern hemisphere after June, or you can say in the last week of June, this start movement, but its impact on low air pressure area is developed by September, by the month of September. The low air pressure area lies here that is start to move towards south along with the sun. With the southward movement of sun, low pressure area or the monsoon trough is started to move towards south. How the monsoon winds withdraws? Suppose this trough is lying here this way, and last week of September or by 15th September, this trough is started to shift towards south. And suppose shifting takes place in this way, first position of the trough is this, and next position of the trough, suppose this. So this area, this western margin of trough, from here has come to this area now. So from this area, when the monsoon was reaching up to this area, now last limit of reach of monsoon becomes this. And from this area, the monsoon starts to withdraw, or this area is left by the monsoon. This area is left by the monsoon. So we'll say monsoon has withdrawn from this area. And this, again, this shifting is due to the shifting of this monsoon trough or low air pressure belt from north to south. So by 15th September, the monsoon shifting generally takes place up to here. Now, last entry of monsoon is up to Delhi, or you can say the southeastern part of Haryana, and monsoon trough हैज कम विद वेस्टर्न मार्जिन इन दिस एरिया एंड दिस एरिया द मॉनसून ट्रफ हैज कम दिस एरिया. सो दिस वे शिफ्टिंग ऑफ मॉनसून टुवर्ड्स इंडियन ओशन और विदड्रॉल ऑफ मॉनसून फ्रॉम इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट टेक्स प्लेस एंड पर्टिकुलरली नॉर्थ इंडिया. दिस विदड्रॉल ऑफ मॉनसून इज रादर ग्रेजुअल, इज स्लो. इन नॉर्थ इंडिया विदड्रॉल इज स्लो बिकॉज हीटिंग ऑफ द नॉर्दर्न पार्ट इज स्टिल देयर बाय द मंथ ऑफ सेप्टेंबर एंड मूवमेंट ऑफ दिस मॉनसून ट्रफ और लो प्रेशर बेल्ट इज ग्रेजुअल एंड स्लो. बट बाय द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर द एंटायर नॉर्दर्न इंडिया इज अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ विदड्रॉल ऑफ मॉनसून. मीन्स बाई 15th October, the monsoon has withdrawn from entire North Indian plains. 15th of October. And then slowly the monsoon trough reaches in Bay of Bengal and shifting of monsoon back or withdrawal of monsoon is started from central part of India. And in South India, this withdrawal of monsoon is rather fast because then fastly the monsoon trough shifted from the part of India and it reaches this trough generally by the November. This monsoon trough is shifted to the central part of Bay of Bengal and this is the part when the monsoon trough is catching the tropical cyclone and that these tropical cyclone attack the coastal plains, particularly Tamil Nadu and the Andhra Pradesh coast. This trough is also responsible for the activeness of the tropical cyclones in Bay of Bengal. So, by the month of December, the trough has left entire part of India. But December, this trough can be having the influence in this southern part and even sometimes the rainfall is caused by the location of this trough in the southeastern part of Kerala and southwestern part of Tamil Nadu. So, this is how the monsoon withdraws from the country. Now let us discuss the climatic conditions in India more deeply, and this can be discussed under the influence of season, cycle of seasons. To understand the climate of India more deeply, minutely or specifically, we have to understand this cycle of seasons. And this cycle of seasons, as you know, in general, is experienced in India, but cycle of seasons most effectively experienced in North India. Cycle of seasons in North India. In South India, this cycle of seasons is not so prominent. So, in cycle of seasons, we have four seasons. Number one, let us start with cold weather season. That is from in 3 months, December, January and February. Then number two, hot weather season. This is in the month of March, April, May. And number three, एडवांसिंग मॉनसून सीजन दैट इज इन द मंथ ऑफ जून जुलाई अगस्त एंड सेप्टेम्बर एंड नंबर फोर दैट इज रिट्रेटिंग मॉनसून सीजन रिट्रेटिंग मॉनसून सीजन एंड दैट इज अक्टूबर एंड नवंबर दो सो दिस साइकिल ऑफ सीजन वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम कोल्ड वेदर सीजन दिसंबर जनवरी फेब्रुवरी देन इज फॉलोड बाई हॉट वेदर सीजन मार्च अप्रैल मई देन एडवांसिंग मॉनसून सीजन जून जुलाई अगस्त एंड सेप्टेम्बर एंड देन रिट्रीटिंग मॉनसून सीजन अक्टूबर एंड नवंबर सो कंप्लीट साइकिल ऑफ सीजन इफ वी विल स्टडी माइन्यूटली एंड डीपली मंथ वाइज मंथ टू मंथ एंड सीजन टू सीजन देन वी कैन experience the better learning of climate of India. So let us start with cold weather season first. That is December, January and February. And when we study cold weather season, we will take to understand all the elements of climate and weather in this season. Suppose first element we will see temperature, second element condition of air pressure, third element is winds, fourth is humidity. And fifth, we will see precipitation. Precipitation. So under the influence of these elements of weather and climate, we shall study the conditions of temperature, air pressure, winds, humidity and precipitation in this season. How this season is affecting these conditions and in this season how we shall see the condition of these elements. So we know by the month of December the sun has shifted in southern hemisphere or in December and January the sun is vertical in southern hemisphere over Tropic of Cancer and by this time this entire North Indian landmass start to become cold and low temperature conditions are developed in entire North India. Temperature is low in entire North India and average temperature conditions even in this area we can see the isotherm of 15 degree C, 15 degree C in northern India but in South India temperature still remains high because this is the part of tropical zone and the coastal areas under the influence of ocean, this area we will see temperature is not low and we can say in North India cold conditions are there but in South India this we can say that this well developed winters are not found in South India and even temperature here can be the 20 to 25 degree centigrade 20 to 25 degree centigrade in South India 20 to 25 degree centigrade in South India So this difference of temperature in South India and North India is about 10 degrees centigrade. So generally we can see this distribution of temperature, that temperature conditions in India increases from north to south, or temperature conditions in India in this region decreases from south to north. And very simple fact we can understand, when temperature is low in North India, then we will see how air pressure is affected. In North India, temperature is low, so air pressure starts to develop as high. So high air pressure conditions start to develop in entire North India. And as we see in South India, because temperature is high, so air pressure is low. And this is more low over the Indian Ocean. So simple way, we will see the system of wind will be from north to south, from high pressure area in North India towards low air pressure area in South India, and further low air pressure area over the Indian Ocean, because equatorial factor is found in Indian Ocean. So how the winds will be developed in this region? Again, we will see the direction of wind will be affected by topography. So in North Indian plain, the direction of wind is this. And in this area, the direction of wind, we can see this, because the air descends down from Himalayas. And over Himalayas, because pressure is rather more high, so this can be the direction of wind here. And even sometimes the direction of wind in this area can be like this. In Brahmaputra Valley, this direction of wind, and over Ganga Plain, this direction of wind, and here the normal direction of wind over Bay of Bengal, that is northeast. So in this area also, direction of wind this. Sometimes, because eastern ghats, the direction of wind can be seen like this, and here direction of wind this, direction of wind this. This way the winds are blowing. So this is the general pattern of winds in Indian subcontinent. And these winds are blowing under the influence of high air pressure area in North India and low pressure area in South India. One more feature is important here, that in this part of India, anticyclonic conditions are developed, and these anticyclonic conditions always making the winds to move outward, and these winds in anticyclonic conditions also blow outward from land to sea. So general pattern of winds is from land to sea, and when these winds are blowing from land to sea, these winds do not contain humidity. The winds do not contain humidity, and in vast area, in maximum areas of India or Indian subcontinent, the conditions are with poor precipitation or poor rainfall. But exceptions can also be seen in this element here. Exception is seen in this area, this Tamil Nadu coast. Because when these winds are moving from Bay of Bengal, they pick up moisture, and after picking up moisture, they strike to eastern ghats here, and in this area rainfall is caused. So in winter season, this is the only area of the country in South India where winter is caused. Other exception of rainfall in winter season, as we have learned, is this part, this entire part of India. Even the rainfall sometimes it reaches up to Brahmaputra Valley. And we know this rainfall is due to the inflow of western disturbances. Western disturbances or temperate cyclones. Let me remind you that these cyclones are coming from west direction, from Mediterranean Sea, Persian Gulf, Caspian Sea, Red Sea. They pick up moisture, and under the influence of westerly jet, these temperate cyclones or western disturbances enters in India. And in plain, they cause light rainfall in plains, and this rainfall is maximum in northwestern parts of plain, taking from Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi. And as we move towards east, amount of rainfall is decreasing. And as I told you that sometimes these temperate cyclones reaches up to Assam in Brahmaputra Valley, and rainfall is caused in this area also. But rainfall, amount of rainfall is decreasing towards east, west to east. And in Himalayas, they cause light to heavy snowfall, and this snowfall also decreases from west to east. In western Himalaya, maximum snowfall and maximum accumulation of snow and ice is done in winter season due to the influence of western disturbances and tropical cyclones. And the snowfall is decreasing towards east. So this is the condition in cold weather season in the entire country. And all these climatic conditions we have understood under the influence of temperature, air pressure, winds, humidity, precipitation. So two main features, once I will repeat: the western disturbances cause rainfall in plains and snowfall in Himalayas, and the coastal plains of Tamil Nadu is experiencing the rainfall due to the picking up moisture by the northeast monsoon and causing rainfall in this area. So one main feature of these temperate cyclones is not only rainfall but creating the cold wave in entire plain. And cold wave under the influence of temperate cyclones and rainfall reduces the temperature in North India. Other factor which reduces the temperature in North India is the wind, the air which is coming down from Himalayas. Particularly when there is heavy snowfall in Himalayas, and the chilly winds when they descend down from Himalayas and enters in North India, they reduce the temperature in North India. So these are certain climatic phenomena which control the temperature in North India: western disturbance and the descending chilly winds from Himalayas. And already we have learned that in South India there is no seasonal change affected, and in South India even the effect of summers we can see in this season, even in the cold weather season. Now let us see these conditions in hot weather season. Number two, hot weather season and the months March, April and May. Hot weather season. Again, the five elements temperature, number two, air pressure, number three, winds, number four, humidity, and number five, precipitation. Now, by the month of March, the temperature starts to rise in North India. This is comparatively more in South India, as we know, because South India is under the influence of tropical condition, in tropical zone. But by the month of March, temperature starts to rise in North India. And by the month of April and May, this North Indian plain starts to get heated intensively. Intensive heating started in North India by the month of May. And once again, you see, this simple influence is of the sun. This happens due to the northward movement of the sun, which starts after the month of December. Northward movement of the sun starts by the end of December, and by the end of May, this effect of temperature is very effectively registered in North India. High temperature in North India. So, general conditions of temperature, we can see even by the month of May, the temperature here can reach up to 45 to 50 degree centigrade. 45 to 50 degree centigrade in western part of Rajasthan, in even western part of Punjab, this temperature about 40 degree C can reach. And in general conditions in this area, at various places, temperature 40 degree centigrade. 40 degree centigrade. So, general trend of temperature, we can see this is rising from south to north, or temperature is decreasing from north to south. Decreasing from north to south, or increasing from south to north. These are the temperature conditions in hot weather season. And when temperature conditions are like this, so here it starts to set up the conditions of low air pressure in northern plain. Start to set up the conditions of low air pressure in North India. So air pressure conditions low in North India and comparatively high towards South India. So how the winds will start to set up here? In North India, the important feature of wind is sometimes move this. Westerly winds move in North India, and you know these winds are very hot winds, which are very popularly known in North India, Lu. So this setting up of Lu starts by the month of May, and by the end of May, Lu are very strongly blowing, particularly in North India. So these features of hot winds, Lu, are mainly in North India. Even sometimes the effect of Lu can go up to Orissa. Bihar is also there, but Orissa, in this area, Madhya Pradesh, all these states can be under the influence of Lu. And this is very simple, that Lu is created by the hot surface of the land. When air comes under the influence of hot surface of the land, these winds blow over the land. And when they come from the hot sandy rocks of Rajasthan, these winds are more hot. And definitely, when these winds are hot, and exposure of people, animals, and crops against these winds is causing the sometimes fatal conditions, and several times people in North India die due to the influence of low. And even just I said, sometimes up to Orissa, the low is affecting the life of the people. So general condition of winds start to set up from north to south in this season under the influence of low air. इसको नॉर्थ टू साउथ वाले को हटा देना भाई, नॉर्थ टू साउथ. सो जनरल कंडीशंस ऑफ विंड जनरल कंडीशंस ऑफ विंड्स आर सेटिंग इन नॉर्थ इंडिया अराउंड दिस लो प्रेशर बेल्ट. एंड मेन फीचर ऑफ विंड इन नॉर्थ इंडिया इज the dust storm. By the month of April and May, these local dust storms are set up, and these local dust storms are set up around the low air pressure conditions in North India. So these dust storms sometimes have some moisture with them, and in the evening generally these dust storms come and they are set up to the high rising temperature by the 3 or 4 p.m. and sometimes by 5 and 6 p.m. because by that time temperature is high, and this high temperature creates low air pressure conditions, and due to these low air pressure conditions, these dust storms are set up. Sometimes they are descending down from Himalayas. The winds descending down from Himalayas and sometimes from western side. And once again I tell you, when these dust storms are having some moisture, they cause light rainfall also. And this light rainfall followed by the cool breeze is giving a sigh of relief by the scorching heat in North India. And in this part, in Bengal and Assam, these local dust storms are converted into thunder storms in this part. And here in this part they are known as, particularly in Bengal and part of Assam, Kal Baisakhi. Kal Baisakhi. Because in this area these storms are more strong, and the velocity of wind is also high, and sometimes this speed is so much that they cause huge destruction to the life and property. Now let us understand why these storms are strong in Bengal and Assam. Because from Himalayas and lower pressure in this valley, so lower pressure of this valley attracts these winds from Himalayas, and fastly these winds descend down from Himalayas. And as these winds come in this low air pressure, in this low air pressure area of valley, the strength of the winds become strong and they become destructive in Bengal and Assam. So Kal Baisakhi is the local and notorious term given to these dust, these storms. I must not say them dust storm, but these storms. Now this is the main feature of wind system in North India. And now how the North India and how in North India the winds are not caused by this month, because humidity with the air is low. So in North India rainfall is also not caused because of the low humidity. But in South India the pattern of wind system is different. Because in South India, by the month of May, the air from ocean is attracted by the coastal plains, particularly the coastal plains of Kerala and Karnataka. Because in these coastal plains, comparatively low air pressure area is developed. And these winds from Arabian Sea, locally here are known as pre-monsoon shower. Pre-monsoon shower is caused by these winds, and locally these pre-monsoon showers in Kerala coast and Karnataka coast, particularly in this area, these are known as mango showers. So let us understand this phenomena here in Kerala coast and Karnataka coast. Just I told you that low air pressure is start to set up in coastal plains, and the air is attracted by the Indian Ocean, by Arabian Sea. And because this low air pressure condition is not very strong, so comparatively less moist air is attracted by these coastal areas, and light rainfall is caused in coastal areas. And this influence of this winds is not going in inner part of the peninsular plateau, because the western ghats stop the influence of these winds to make the entry in inner part of the peninsular plateau. So this is other important feature in this season, hot weather season in Kerala coast, Karnataka coast, pre-monsoon shower or mango shower. Mango shower, it is known because by these showers, there is early ripening of mango in these parts, and suddenly the mango crop is affected by mango shower. So these are the conditions of temperature, air pressure, winds, humidity and precipitation in hot weather season. Once again, we should be noting these features. Number one, low in this part. Number two, dust storms. In this part, and Kal Baisakhi in this part, and pre-monsoon shower mainly in coastal part of Karnataka and Kerala. This is how we can understand deeply or minutely the climatic conditions or weather conditions in hot weather season, March, April and May. Theek hai babu?